Welcome to Single Serving Excel. Today we're going to learn how to remove personal information from a workbook. Let's say you have a workbook with your name, company, address, phone number, along with the purchase order amounts for the clients you're doing business with. We also have another worksheet that contains our employee names and their salaries. This morning you got an email from a potential client asking who you're currently doing business with, so you decide to send this workbook. You don't want them to see all the personal information, so you hide columns A, B, and E, and you also decide to hide all your employee names and their salaries. The problem is, the person can simply unhide the columns and worksheet to see what you are hiding. It's a good idea to review your workbook for hidden or personal data that's in your spreadsheet or in the document properties. Even though our spreadsheet is small and we can simply delete those pieces of information, but what if you have a large spreadsheet with many hidden rows, columns, and worksheets? Go to the File menu tab, click on Check for Issues, then click on Inspect Document. And you'll get a pop-up message that says, before you use Document Inspector, make sure you save your changes because the Document Inspector might remove the data that can't be restored later. Do you want to save your file now? Just go ahead and click yes. The Document Inspector dialog box opens and it tells you all the items that it'll be checking for. Leave all boxes checked and click on the Inspect button. You'll see that it found information in the Document Properties and Personal Information box, Hidden Rows and Columns, and Hidden Worksheets. Let's go ahead and click on Remove All for each section. It's a good idea to re-inspect your worksheet to make sure everything was removed. It looks like it didn't find anything this time. Click on the Close button. You'll now notice that all the hidden columns are gone, and the worksheet that we hid can no longer be unhid because it's removed. Your workbook is now safe to send. If you have any questions or suggestions for future videos, leave a comment in the section below. Also, like and subscribe and click the bell icon for updates on new videos.